Hello students, in this video we are going to study about a jumbo, which is the equipment which is used by drill and blast method. So what is drill and blast method? It is mostly used method for excavation throughout the world. This method can be used in all types of rocks, and the initial cost is lower than the mechanical method like TBM. This TBM method will be further studied in detail. This method involves the use of explosives. In this, the excavation rate is also less than the machine called TBM, which is usually 3 meters to 5 meters per day. Now we will see the typical cycle of excavation by the drilling and blasting method. So the first step is drilling blast holes and loading them with the explosives. Next step is detonating the blast, followed by ventilation to remove the blast fumes. Next step, removal of blasted rock, which is also called as mucking. Next step, scaling crown and walls to remove the loosened pieces of the rock due to blasting. Next step, installing initial ground support, and the last step is advancing rail, ventilation and other utilities. Now we will see what is a jumbo drill. So jumbo drill is a portable structure made up of steel members in shape and size such that it is capable of moving in and out of the tunnel for working process. It provides one or more working platforms on which the rock drills of the drifter class are mounted, and the operating staff is able to stand and move during the drilling operation. So this is a jumbo drill machine. Okay. In this, the platform decks are adequately spaced depending upon the size of the tunnel. It also permits the drills to be located in any desired position to the drilling pattern used. The compressed air mains are laid along the tunnel wall, and these can be quickly connected to the distribution system of the jumbo drill machine. So now we will see the types of jumbo. There are three types of drilling jumbos, which is, first is the mainline drilling jumbo, second straddle type drilling jumbo, and the third type is a truck mounted drilling jumbo. So now we will see the types of jumbo. There are three types of jumbos. The first type is mainline drilling jumbo, second type straddle type drilling jumbo, and the third type is a truck mounted drilling jumbo. First part, or the first type, is the mainline drilling jumbo. It has a collapsible platforms on the sides which are raised into the horizontal position for drilling, charging and setting the tunnel supports. The platforms are dropped to allow the other equipment to pass when it is moved back from the face. Also, it is parked at the siding during the mucking in case of being a rail type. So, the mainline drilling jumbo can be rail mounted or wheel mounted. So, after mucking, the mucker is removed or moved to a siding before the mainline jumbo is moved to the face of the tunnel. So this is a mainline jumbo drill. Second type, straddle type drilling jumbo. In this type of jumbo, the rides on the wheels moving on wide track rail near the sides of the invert of the tunnel. So it has wheels, it moves on the wide track rail near the sides of the tunnel. In this, the central platforms may be dropped to allow other equipment to pass through. So, in this, the before blasting, jumbo is moved away from the face, and after the mucking is over, it is moved back to the face. The rail mounted jumbos in both mainline type and the straddle type are provided with air motors for moving them with ease. So, this is a straddle type jumbo drill. Third type, truck mounted drilling jumbo. It is used for a short tunnels. So the truck mounted jumbos may be fixed or collapsible. Now it has a deck which can be fixed or collapsible, and it is moved away after each blast to permit the access for other equipments. So especially this type of jumbo are used both for short tunnels and large tunnels. Okay, now we will see for large tunnels. So on large tunnels, two truck mounted jumbos, each covering half of the tunnel area, are used for drilling and are parked end to end during the mucking process to allow the space for other equipment. So this is a truck mounted drilling jumbo. Now we will see the drilling and blasting sequence using jumbo drill equipment. So the first step is drilling. So before the blasting takes place, the drilling rig bores drill the holes. It is determined in advance in a blasting plan in the foremost front wall of the tunnel that where the holes are to be drilled. More the solid rock, more explosives are required for blasting purpose. Now a jumbo is used to drill holes in the rock face, which has three drilling arms and an operating tower. It is run by electric cable, a hose in which a hose brings water to the drills. The drills are pneumatic, it means that the drill beats both the hammer and also it can rotate. The broken bits of the rock are flushed out by the water, where the drill holes are long as 2.4 meters to 3.6 meters. The first sets are straight holes, which is parallel cut and located around the edge of the face and in the middle of the face of the tunnel. A second set, which is V-cut, is angled towards the center. This allows the rock to be blown away from the face into the drift or the tunnel. So this is how the drilling takes place. Loading and blasting. The drill holes are now filled with explosives, in which the detonators are attached to the explosive device and the individual explosive device are connected to one another. The holes are blasted in a proper sequence from center outward, one after the other. Although more than 100 explosions may be set off one after the other, the blast sequence is completed in several seconds. So this is how the detonators are attached into the holes. Next step, ventilating. Now after the blasting, it causes lots of rock to be flung through the tunnel, dispersing clouds of dust that then mix with the combustion gases of the explosion. So that the workers can resume working of the tunnel, the bad air must be removed from the tunnel. So this ventilating is done by using so-called air ducting systems of long steel or plastic pipes, which are attached to the roof of the tunnel, and it blows fresh air into the working phase. It gives rise to localized excess pressure and the bad air is pushed towards the tunnel exit. So this is the ventilation done into the tunnel, where the pipes are provided at the top of the tunnel. Dislodging. So it is stripping away and removal of loose pieces of rock which were not completely released from the rock during the blasting procedure. This working step is completed by a robust tunnel excavator. This is a robust tunnel excavator. Next step, removing rubble. After the loose pieces of the rock have been dislodged from the working phase, the blasted material, that is the rubble or the spoil, is carried out of the tunnel. The material is either loaded onto the dump trucks with wheel loaders and taken from the tunnel to an outside landfill, or it is transported from the site of excavation to the landfill on the conveyor belts. So this is how the excavated earth or the excavated tunnel face is being taken and loaded into the truck. Next, securing. This is depending on the type of rock. A variety of security measures can be implemented in this, that is by using wire mesh, tunnel arches, stakes, or also called as bolts, which can be driven into the rock. The final method for stabilizing rock faces is most commonly the rock bolting. A jumbo is again used in the securing process for drilling the holes into the rock. Here again the holes vary from the meters long as 2.4 meters to 6 meters. Next, a steel rod with a wedge threaded on the end is inserted with the hole. Now, when it is in place, the rod is turned so that it pulls out against the wedge, forcing it into the walls of the hole. The outside end of the rod is secured with a steel plate and a large nut. The geologist and the engineers determine the spacing and depth of the rock bolts required for the condition according to their site. So, under the poorest ground conditions, it may be necessary to put steel arches in place to hold up the walls and the roof of the tunnel. In other situations, a steel mesh may be secured to the walls and roof to prevent other loose material from falling on the workers below. So this is how a securing is done, where rock bolting is done. Now next is the geological mapping. Now the working face is freely accessible and the geologist has few minutes to map it. In this process, the geologist determines that the type of rock which is present, how it lies, whether they are in dip position or flat or in steep manner, they are folded or even broken. We have been studied this rock types or rock patterns in your subject called geology. Now in this, a special compass is used, which is used to measure the angle of incidence and the direction of incidence to the rock structures. The strength of the rock, reaction of the rock, and the mass to the excavation process and the mountain water filtration are also documented in the geological mapping process. Next, the mapping report, which is created from the survey or mapping, it is being produced with sketches and photos, which serves as the basis for selection of appropriate supporting measures. So this is how a geological mapping is done. Next, drilling pattern design. This design ensures the distribution of explosive in the rock and desired blasting result. The several factors must be taken into account when designing the drilling pattern. Now, the next step, drilling pattern design. So this design or this pattern design ensures the distribution of explosive in the rock and desired blasting result. The several factors must be taken into account when designing the drilling pattern. First, the rock drillability and the blastability, even the type of explosives, blast vibration restrictions and its accuracy. So this is how the drilling and the blasting sequence takes place. So drilling is done, loading, blasting, ventilating, dislodging. Scaling is, that means the mucking out. Bolting, surveying, that is geological mapping, and again the jumbo drill is used and the process or the operation in sequence is repeated. Thank you.